What is going on, guys? This is Mr. DanCan18 again, coming at you with the next episode of our Farming Simulator 2013 Let's Play. And this one should be fun because, as you can see, we almost have $1 million. And what we're going to do is start our dairy farm. We're going to start feeding some cows and getting that money from all that milk. So, let's... Yeah, that one's... There's an auction going on for that one, but we don't need it. So... I believe I have, yeah, I drove the harvester on down here, the one that we're never using anymore. So what I'm going to do is jump out and sell this one. Yep. That should be the header. Yeah. Yep. Anything else? Okay. There is no vehicle in there anymore. All right. Let's see. So let's jump in over here. Let's make sure we're not fast-forwarding time. We're not. And I've got the missions off for now because this should be a full episode. All right, let's jump in. Our favorite tractor here. Drop the trailer. And let's drive it over to the moo cow place. Actually, wait a minute. I'm about to buy a whole bunch of stuff. So... let's reset this guy to the farm and then drive it down. Okay, that. And drive it down to the store. No, not that. That. Okay. So, let's jump back in this. Kind of reminds me of my own job. I drive a forklift at my own job. Ugh, don't do that. Okay, let's pick this back up. Cue. Alright, lift it up a little bit. Alright, so let's drive down to the store. You know what? Let's go ahead and grab this trailer. I'm all over the place at the moment. I'll get it worked out. Because we're going to sell this trailer too. We don't need it. Come on. Alright. Drive this down and sell it. That should put us over $1 million. It's pretty cool. And then we'll buy all the stuff we need for our dairy farming, which is going to be fun. All right. See if I can get this trailer in that box without too much trouble. See if I can do it without having to back up. And turn. Wonder if that'll work. Let's jump out. Yep. Yep. Alright, so now, let's go to the store. Alright, so we are going to need... Come on. I mean, I realize we have a cedar. And we're only going to have to plant grass into that small field over next to our dairy farm once. So do we waste the 4,500 bucks? Or do we drive the cedar over? I think I'll drive the cedar over to save some money. All right. Mowers. Here we are. We need this guy. This is the front one, right? Yeah, front mounted. That guy. We're going to need this windrower. We're going to need this tedder, right? Yeah. We're going to need the... This does square bales, right? Yep, I think. And that's round bells. Ooh, glad I read that. Okay. This really cool auto stacker. Man, it's good to have money, isn't it? Just buy everything. Alright, is that? Oh yeah, we need this guy. And this is to make the mixed rations, which is what the moo cows really, really like. Did I buy that? Ooh, I don't want to buy it twice on accident. Look at all of her stuff. All right. I didn't buy it. Is that it? For now, I believe that's it. Yeah, check out all of her stuff. All right. What I may have to do is reset. Oh, it's going to take forever. See, display. We're going to turn those off. Yeah, so let's reset that back up to the farm so that we can put the mowers on this. You know what? I bet I didn't have to do that. That was dumb. It doesn't matter because I'm going to be driving through there a bunch anyways. I could reset all this back up to the farm to get it a little closer, and I may end up doing that. Am I backing up in the right direction? I don't think I am. Yeah, I'm a big stupid. All right, we'll drive around. Yeah, I could cheat and just reset all this to the farm. But we'll at least do this first trip from here. Ugh. Okay. And where's the front of that thing? I believe it's this way. Get the that up out of the way. Ooh. Okay. Alright. Let's drive this transformer over to the dairy farm. Oh, no. Okay. Alright, so we're on our way. Very cool. Yeah, and if you remember at the end of the last episode, I talked about excuse me, how I was going to replant barley on two of my fields so that I could harvest those and have it lay down some the straw so that I can bale it for the dairy farm for the cows. And the reason I was going to do barley was because off camera there had been a great demand for barley, so I was going to end up selling the barley. Well, when I came back into the game to do that, to prepare for this episode, I reloaded it and that great demand was gone, so I wasted some money. You know, I shouldn't say wasted. I missed out on some money, but we're okay. We still have half a mil left. Oh, and I also added a little chaff to this silo right over here that's near the dairy farm so that we could get the silage made for to use for the mixed ration. Okay, let's drop. Let's turn a little bit. Okay, let's get all this put over here. Thank you. All right. So let's cheat a little. Reset him. Let's go ahead and reset all this stuff. Save us a little time. Bunch of stuff. Okay. Okay, we're going to leave the baler here because we're going to be using that, obviously. So let's jump in our feeder here, our mixer. This thing's cool. Makes life really easy. honestly, I don't know how you would make... Is there another way to make mixed ration without this? Is there a cheaper version? I've never not used it. All right, guys, what I'm going to do... I'm not going to make you, watch me make this drive about 5 more times. Maybe not quite that many more times, but we'll need to get the wind rower over there and the tedder. The baler, of course, will have to stay for now, at the farm, at the main farm over here, because that's where we'll bale the straw that's on our main fields. And the baling automatic trailer will also have to stay over there on our main farm. But I will drive the seeder over also, purchase the field, and seed the grass. I'll let you guys see that, of course. But I've got to make about at least like 3 more trips over. So I'll see you guys in just a second. Won't make you watch that. Okay, guys, what I decided to do here, I brought the seeder on over. There's a few more things I still have to bring. But I'm going to go ahead and buy this field and get it seeding the grass so we can get things going here. So 22,000, not a big deal. Run back over here with the loudest tractor ever, apparently. Turn my headphones down. There we go. All right, jump in. And we've got it on grass. Hire a worker. All right, so we're going to jump back over here. I made one additional purchase that I remembered when I wasn't recording. You see that I didn't even have to bring this fork. That's a pallet fork. Over, I should have left it over with the sheep, and I purchased this bale fork. It's what you pick up the bales of hay and straw with. Not a big deal. It was only $1,000. So we'll drive, I've got the tedder on the back, and we'll drive this on over, and then while it's still seeding the grass, we can start baling some hay. Excuse me, straw. So, we're almost there. We got it going. Good thing this little guy's fast. But I'll drop the bale fork and the tedder. Probably reset this guy back to the farm and use him to do the baling. I'm trying to think of how many cows I want to purchase after we get everything set up. See, I think we have 50 sheep. Sounds like a good number. How much are the cows? $2,000. It's not so bad. I guess I could speed up once the grass gets planted, and it shouldn't take long for that guy to do it with that big seeder. Good Lord, it's almost done. I guess I could speed up plant growth. It affects grass too, right? I've never really paid attention to that. Somebody let me know if you know that. Let's see, let's drop that. And let's drop the bale fork. I usually put the bales of hay and straw back over here against the back of the where the cows come in and bed and stuff and to feed. So I'll put the bale fork right here. We got our mixer right over there. Okay, we're gonna reset this guy and go bale some hay. Where am I at? There we are. Jump back over here. And I said it again. Bale some straw. Always do that. Alright, so let's pick our baler up. This is when it would be good to be doing a multiplayer. To have a partner working with you that could come pick up the bales. All right. think you can set it on cruise control too. And it'll bail at that speed. This again is one of those things that you can't hire the worker to do. You have to drive it yourself. Let's jump over here and see if it's done. It's finishing now. Alright, so let's reset this guy back. Get him out of the way. Jump back in. Well, let's do this. Let's speed it up. Whoops. Alright. There. Okay. Alright, so turn Baylor on. We're going to try cruise control too. Alright. Is it picking it up? Yep. Cool. Now we're bailing some straw. Yeah, I've never really done the round ones. It just seemed easier to stack and store, you know, using the square ones. So let me know if you guys want me to maybe eventually do one of those, do a round one. See how it works. All right, swing around. Make the turn. I missed some. I'll go back and get it. Should start dropping them out soon. Great demand at the end on wheat. Let's check it out, see how much wheat we have. $80,000. Money is not a huge issue, and I would prefer to keep doing this. I don't know, I'll think about it. Make the turn. Alright, and it just poops them out. Alright, I've got 3 fields to do this with. So I'll continue this process. And then I'll catch you up once we are picking them up with that automatic trailer, which is pretty cool. Alright, see you guys when we start doing that. Okay guys, finishing up the last row here. In our baling process, we have a whole bunch of hay bales now. 3 fields worth. Straw bales. Good lord, I did it again. Anyways, and so next step, we're going to grab our trailer that automatically picks these bales up for us. So we got it all picked up. So let's hit the old B button and turn that off. Drop this back off at our farm. House here, the parking lot, whatever you want to call it. And we'll grab the trailer. Now, I have more than one load of these bales of straw, so I'm thinking I may sell the first load right there where that question mark is. Haven't done that yet. That's why that question mark's still there. So let's drop this off over here and grab the trailer. We may sell the first load and then take the second load to the dairy farm. So let's hit the queue, grab the trailer. I need to grab those eggs. I'll do that off camera. But we'll see how many I end up with. So before we sell them and then accidentally have sold them before we, you know, realize we needed them. All right. So let's drive this over to the large field. It's very froggy, as my daughter calls it. And I can show you this here. We're all grown on field 35. Our grass is grown. So we can begin cutting that grass. You know what? That may be what I do. I may just grab a full load of straw here, straw bales, and then drive them on over there and leave the others. Sell them off camera. We'll see. All right, so let's hit. Was it B that does it? Yeah. This is a very cool trailer. Does most of the work for us. Because if we didn't do it this way, we would have to use this tractor we have and the bell fork and run around and pick all these up and put them on a trailer. That would suck. So you just drive through and grab them up. This guy I work with that actually has a little farm, and he sells bales of straw and hay, you know, to local other farms and stuff for to feed horses and things like that, and cattle. And he has one of these automatic picker-upper trailers. I think that's the technical term for it. I think I'm gonna try to go by his farm and take my daughter and let her see all the animals and stuff and check this out, because that seems very, very cool. See if we can get all these picked up. I think it holds 18. Whoops. Didn't give it time. Whoops, my bad. Oh. Let's see if I can swing it back around. Line it up. Okay. I think it holds 18. Okay, so that's 12. Is this the last one on this field? Wish it wasn't so foggy so I could see. One more over there. Okay, I think that's this field. So that field gave us 13. Let's hit B so we don't catch that on something. We may as well go ahead and fill up the trailer, so. So I don't think, we may not sell any then. We may just leave the other bales laying there for when we need more. Now obviously we're gonna have more straw bales than hay, because the hay bales are going to come from that, whoa, there's one over here, let me grab it. Come from that smaller field of grass we're going to cut. But we need less hay bales than we do straw bales. The straw bales also serve as bedding for the moo-moo cows. You'll see that process too, hopefully at some point in this episode. This may be a long episode. That's why I'm trying to edit out some of the more mundane processes. Okay, we're at 100%, so let's back on up a little bit so we don't run that over. Hit the old B. All right, guys. And I'm going to see you over at the dairy farm. I'm going to try to cut out as much as I can because, if not, this episode's going to be forever long or two parts. So, see you guys in a second. Okay, guys, so I'm over here now. So, I think we're going to put this up against the wall. See if I can do this. Hope it's not too dark for you guys. I know it's foggy. Let's see. Oh. It's going to tilt it up for us. I don't know why I'm putting them all nice and neat over here, because when I have to get some straw bales, I'm probably going to knock them over because it's too tall for the tractor. Okay, so unload bales here. See, how cool is that? All right, so lower platform. Let's go park this over here, where we've got the rest of our equipment parked. And let's begin cutting some grass and let's make some hay bales. Yeah, this is definitely going to be a longer episode. Hope you guys don't mind. Hit the old Q button. And let's hook up all of our mowing equipment. Come on. Oh. What did I? Why is this leaning? I hit tab instead of Q? On accident? Oh, okay. I guess that's how we do that. Let's go back to what we were doing. All right. Fat fingers. Anyways, so let's hook up the mower. See if I can get swung around. Come on. Almost hit tab again instead of Q. All right, so let's unfold. G again, G, unfold, lower, G, lower, that's lift, so we're already down, so, alright, turn mower on, alright, so I think you can do it at speed 2, so, let's swing around with our transformer. Come to think of it, I've got to cut my own grass today. IRL in real life. So I've only got a push mower. This would do me a lot of good if I had something like this. I could cut it in about 7 minutes. Okay, it says it had grown, but doesn't look very long. Oh well. So yeah, you can make quick work of this small field with this thing. Actually, guys, again, I'm trying to shorten the episode a little bit for you. I'm going to stop the recording for just a second while I can finish this up. Okay, guys, finishing up the grass here. Almost done. All right, so let's start turning it off. Fold it up. All right, fold them on up. Got it cut, so we're going to run over here and grab the tedder. The tedder is what agitates it and turns it into hay for us, because right now that's just cut grass, obviously. Okay. Oops, my bad. Back up. We got stuck? No. Okay. Drop it. All right, spin around. Drop it. Okay, cool. Now let's pick up the tedder. Then the windrower. Alright. Unfold. Lower. Control 2 and turn it on. All right. All right, same deal, guys. Sorry for all the cuts. I'm just trying to not make this 2.5 hours long. See you guys when I'm almost done with this one, then we'll grab the windrower. All right, guys. Finishing up with the tedder here. So we're almost done. And fold it up. Okay. We'll grab the windrower. What the windrower does is it takes this field of hay and puts it in nice, neat rows for us, like I was using the baler for the straw. Those nice, neat rows it's in is what makes it so easy to pick up with the baler. And speaking of the baler, I'll have to go pick it up because it's still back at our main farm. So I will run and pick it up after using the windrower, of course. So with the next cut, you probably won't see me park the windrower. You'll see me coming back with the baler. All right, so let's drive it over. unfold. There are cheaper versions. I mean, you probably saw the cheaper one than this. Let's turn it on. I can't do multiple things at once. You probably saw the cheaper one than this, but this has two attachments, for lack of a better word. I'm not sure what to call it. And so it puts it in a line for you automatically. The one that is cheaper than this only has one blade spinning, so you have to drive down both sides of the row to make it a line, if that made sense. All over the place. Yeah, I actually made a how-to video. It's one of the first videos I ever made, was a how-to of, you know, how to get your cow's productivity to 100% in producing milk. One of the first ones I ever made. It's actually kind of funny to go back and listen to it, because that heel screwed me up, because I screw it up a bunch of times and stuttering all over myself. I still do that, but at least I'm more comfortable with it. I guess I could link that in the description. But this is basically a how-to video within itself, because I'm laying out how to do it. But it does take a while, and you do need a lot of equipment. But it's one of the more fun... keep leaving little spots. One of the more fun things in the game, I believe, because you have to have a little bit... you have to have moved ahead on basically almost everything in the game. You have to know how to harvest chaff and turn it into silage, you know, to do part of the mixed ration. You have to, of course, the main harvesting equipment, you have to have it so that you can take the waste or the straw that comes from the wheat and the barley and bale it, because you're going to need it for straw bales. And you have to be able to do what I'm doing now, which is turn the cut grass into hay, and then cut it into rows, or blow it into rows, or row it into rows, and then bale it, and then put it all together to make the mixed ration. So I mean, it's almost everything in the game that you have to have. So it's pretty awesome. I like it. I mean, I got to thinking about it, and really, all that's left after this is potatoes and sugar beets, which is fun too, but the equipment is very expensive. Really, really expensive. So, I mean, I guess in the comments, let me know. Is it folding? Fold it up. I've hit X about 100 times. There we go. Let me know in the comments what you want to see next. Do you want to see sugar beets or potatoes or what? And I'll begin the process of working toward that. But I'm getting ahead of myself. We're still doing the cows, which I think is what's one of the more fun things in this game. Okay, let's get myself confused again. Oh! Ah, that's close enough. Okay. Still foggy. All right, I'm gonna cheat a little and jump back like that. Let's jump in our tractor that's on its side. Now, I've already forgotten. Did I take the bale fork? I did. It's back over there. So let's grab the baler and drive it back. Right, so now I'm sure you noticed that there's still straw bales in the baler there, and that's not a big deal. What it'll do is when I'm picking up the hay, the next, I think, two that it poops out will be straw bales, and then it'll do, if I remember right, about four or five hay bales. and then we'll have hay, about two hay bales waiting in the baler. So the next time we cut the grass and do the process that I just went through, we'll have about 7 hay bales that it'll give us. I think that's about right. And then after this, we'll be able to use the mixer to begin feeding the cows. We'll buy the cows and then we'll let them get to 100%. I'm not sure of the times that the milkman comes by to pick up the milk. So I'd like to get that on video and let him come by and we'll see how much money it makes us. But we'll see. Speaking of sugar beets and potatoes that I mentioned earlier, those two fields that we can't see because of the fog, but that I drove past, that's just up the hill from the main farm, that's what I'll probably use for the potatoes and the sugar beets, because it's just right up the hill from where our silos are. That is one of the things about this this map, and that's, if we do a season two, which if you guys let me know if you want to do a season two, I'll probably do it in a, you know, one of the downloadable maps or something. But that's one of the things is, let's get to this map. This is our, you know, our main farm here, and that's where our silos are. So it seems very inefficient to me to be like, if we bought field 40 or 1 here that are, you know, they're massive, but during the harvesting process, you know, I'm going to take them way back over there, you know. So Duza, if you're still watching, let me know if there's a if there's a mod for additional silos, and I can, you know, put them in different parts of the map. That'd be cool. Alright, so let's hit B, cruise control 2, and you'll see what I mean here. It just accepts it anyways, and so where it said I think it was in the 30% somewhere for it was, you know, building a or making a new bale of straw, it just becomes a hay bale. So that's how that works. It switches to a hay bale if you start picking. So, but if you see, I dropped a straw bale to my right there, and there's going to be another one, and I think the next one will be hay. Alright guys, again, I think this will be the last cut, but again, this is sort of a mundane process. I'll see you on the other side of it. Okay guys, almost done here, and I was wrong. There was that last bale, it made it a straw bale. So there's 3 straw bales laying out there, and I missed that spot like a dummy, and 4 or 5 hay bales. So let's pick that up, that little bit up. Alright, so let's park him over here. Let's grab our bale fork, and I think the first thing I'm going to do is grab some of these straw bales and lay down some bedding in there first. There's a couple ways to do that. There's machines that are just designed for that, but let me show you what I do so I don't have to buy any additional equipment. Man, I wish this fog would go away so you guys could see, because I know it degrades a little. Even though I uploaded in 720, it degrades a little once I upload it to YouTube. So that's no fun. Okay, so let's pick that up. Let's actually jump out. Run over here to this guy. Get in. Drive him over here. This is what we're going to use to put the straw in there first. I may do a couple of bales of straw. I wonder if it's going to let me do it without purchasing any cows first. Randomly forgot how to get out of the thing for a second. Alright. Jump in our favorite guy here. Let's drive over. Let's go get the straw bales off of the field. You could use the automatic picker-upper guy over there, as I call it. But I figure there's only a few bales, so may as well just come get them myself with the bale fork. Okay, this takes a little practice to be able to do that without killing yourself or embarrassing yourself. By the way, the difference, if you can't tell, is these are more yellow and those are more green. The hay bales there. If you couldn't figure that out. Alright, so. And sort of the secret to get the straw bales and hay bales in here is to make it touch that blade. Move forward a little bit. And it kind of just disappears like that. And then let's throw another one in there. If you leave your forks up like that, or especially if you have a load on there, like a bale of hay, you can flip really easily. I hate this thing sometimes. I swear to God, the equipment I work with at work is easier to drive than trying to do those to manipulate that fork while you're driving. There's one there. Let's see if I can grab it. Ugh. Okay, we got it. Okay, see if I can get it lined up. Sorry for lack of commentary there. It takes some concentration. Is it lined up? Yeah. Bam, son. Okay, back up. Jump out. Okay. Now, it's going to let us do it, so we're going to hit the old Q button. See, it puts their bedding in there. Alright, so we're going to jump out. We're going to mix ration. So we need one bale of hay, one bale of straw, and then we'll fill the remainder up with the silage over there, and that makes the mixed ration, as you'll see in a moment. I hate this thing. There we go. I'm getting pretty good. Okay. Wrong way, you big dummy. Okay. Hope there's another bale of straw out there. I think there is. Yeah, I did say three, right? I'm asking you guys like you're gonna answer. Losing my mind. Alright. Get in there. Got it. Alright, so we have our hay in there. Okay. Let's go get that last bale of straw. Should be that one in the distance. Get in there. Pick it up. Alright. Almost got it. Urgh. Boop. Okay. Alright. That was relatively painless. Jumping this guy, and you see the lines where it wants the different ratios. So it wants the different types of material within those two lines. So what we'll do is we'll pick up silage, and what it'll do is it'll change the ratios of say turn it on. All right. Of the others, you see, and it puts everything within the green. There's the straw. All right. So there you have it. So we now have mixed ration that we'll dump into the feeding trough and buy our moo moo cows. Okay, so Q fills it up. All right. Hurry up. Okay, so now let's buy, what do you think? 25 to start with? Yeah, we'll go ahead and just do 25. Let's jump out. And there's our cows. All right, so let's go scroll through statistics. There you go. You see it's at 100% right now, and that's because we haven't. It's been my experience that you have to switch over to a new hour. So let's get it to the 8 o'clock hour. Maybe the fog will go away in the 8 o'clock hour too. Let's see how this goes. Need more straw in there. You can, as you can see on the PDA there, you can feed them through silage or grass. Yep, the fog went away. And it jumped to 100%, so let's go bring this back down to real time. You can feed them through silage and grass. They only go and begin eating that, after the mixed ration is gone. So they prefer the mixed ration, and that's what keeps them at 100%. So that's why I'm not even going to bother putting the other in. I'll just make sure I keep the mixed ration in. But, guys, we did it. We are now in the business of dairy farming. So leave a comment or a like to let me know what you think. And let me know about the sugar beets and potatoes, because that's what we'll work toward next. Do you want to do the sugar beets first or the potatoes? Because as I can show you, let's see. Like that. That guy is $500,000, you know. And the sugar beets is the same way. I believe it's, yeah. So takes a lot of money to be able to do that, so it takes a bit of preparation. So let me know. But other than that, guys, I'm going to go ahead and get out of here. Appreciate you watching. Thanks, guys.